This video is going to show you how to make a Twitter searching app using AngularJS. You can see I already have Angular set up here, as well as the resource bundle plugin, or whatever the cool kids are calling it these days, and the bootstrap CSS because I can't design worth a crap. So the first thing we're going to do is set up ng app, initializes the app, and then set up our first controller, ng controller, and just call it Twitter CTRL. Now, if you've seen the other videos or the other video of mine, this should all be familiar. If you haven't seen it, then go back and watch it. So we're setting up our Twitter script here, and we'll set up our first controller to match up with our Twitter CTRL here. This will be our Angular controller. Now, if you've read any of the documentation on the resource, you know that you have to inject or pass the resource as a parameter into your controller, but you'll notice if you try and run this now, it will completely bomb on you, and you'll get unknown provider with a whole bunch of cryptic errors at the bottom that you have no idea how to solve until you read the documentation and you realize it's really not all that bad. So we'll just name our module Twitter, and then pass in its requirements, which is simply ng resource. What this does, it sets up our resource provider and it allows resource to be injected. So it satisfies that dependency by setting up this this module for us. And then you can set up more config stuff, more providers and injection logic and stuff. Not gonna do that in this video, but it's available. The one caveat here is that Twitter does need to match up with this right here, Twitter. Very, very important that Twitter and Twitter match up, or else these dependencies in your app will completely fail. So if we rerun this now, you'll see no errors, so we can continue on our merry way. So now that we actually have a resource, let's talk about what it is. So it's basically just a API or anything on the web, locally, whatever. I'm actually just gonna use the Twitter searching API here because it's nice and sexy as opposed to more boring examples that wouldn't do much. So we'll set the resource up as just a Twitter property on our scope. And you can see that if we just simply call Twitter get, which is one of the first methods that a resource gives you, that it'll actually go ahead and try and make a request, but obviously you need to pass in some options to this Twitter search. So the first thing we're going to do is set up the action, and this is just search JSON, as well as the query. And this, you can learn more about this from the Twitter API docs. And the query we'll use by default is just AngularJS. Now this action, what this actually means is that if I type action here, whatever this is will get replaced, or this will get replaced by this guy. So if you look at how this is done, it's going to say search twitter.com and then search JSON with the Q as a parameter, passing in AngularJS. Method isn't allowed. What that means is this simply requires us to use, when we call get, and instead of using just a default get, we're going to change the method to something called JSONP, cross domain JSON loading and all that jazz. So now you can see we're actually in business here. We have loaded some JSON and we have results based on that query that we sent. So far we're actually doing pretty good. What we need to figure out now is how we're going to get this data into our app. It's nice that you can see it in the Firebug console, but that's not doing a whole lot for us quite yet. So as usual, there's a callback property we can set. Now we can set it to something like Twitter search, and then define a function up here called Twitter search, and then check the results. And this is okay. So we got a result back, but that's kind of out of scope of what we want to do. We want to keep things nice and in scope of what this what our app is actually doing. So let's change this to something that's provided to us by Angular, something called JSON Callback, which is going to automatically generate a callback from Angular. So this will allow us to do something like this, where we can say this is better, invoke this guy. You can see this is better because now we can use this callback, which is nice and in scope of our controller, and we could use those properties and everything. But what's even better-er is something that looks a little bit like this. Twitter results. Actually, that might be a bit confusing. Let's just name it Twitter result because there's an array of results on our result here. Now that we have our Twitter results, let's go ahead and loop through them. We'll go ahead and set up a table. And the class of table, and I think it's table striped, and then set up a row, and then set up our looping, ng repeat, and we'll go for each tweet in Twitter result dot results, because if you look through our results here, you can see that there's a list of results on our response. 0 through 7. So in each of these results, we're going to loop through, set up a couple columns. The first column can be, let's just do the text of the tweet. Tweet, and I think that's just text is the property we're looking for. So now that we have this, we magically have a whole bunch of tweets just by using, I can't imagine writing this in any less code, honestly. I think this is just amazing. So we have a resource, we have it set up to point to the search Twitter. This search JSON replaces this action, which makes it nice and flexible, and future examples where I can swap those out. But for right now, that's all we're gonna do. Sets up a default query of AngularJS, and sets up a callback, which is automatically generated for you, which means that this result will get assigned asynchronously once that's done. And then you can just simply loop through the results and start displaying them. So far we're actually doing pretty good. Let's go ahead and add a search button. So we'll set up an input with a type of text. If you remember, what ng model does the two-way binding, and we'll call this our search term, and then we'll set up a button with a class of just button. We all love the icons. Oops, it's not icon, that's icon search. Sounds good to me. And then the text of search. So if we look at this now, we'll have a search box with the search button. Actually, let's line these up a bit. Form with the class of form horizontal. And that'll look a little bit better. So now that we have this, nothing's hooked up, we'll go ahead and set up the click on the button, ng click, just call it do search. And then all we have to do is simply wrap this in a function. And that function is going to be do search. And instead of passing in the default query, we are going to pass in our search term, which is, remember, it's two-way bound to this from the ng model in our input. And then this queue for the query is going to override this one. And if you cross your fingers and you type something great, and hit search, it should just work for you right off the bat. I know I took a roundabout way to write a very little amount of code, so I just want to quickly recap what's going on before I close up here. So we're using Angular with the resource plugin. You have to set up the resource plugin by requiring it here, which will allow you to inject it. You use the resource by passing in the URL that has the resource on it. And then this is swappable. I could have included a action in here if there was another action other than search, but search only has search. And then these defaults can all be replaced. These are parameters, and I could have replaced callback if I wanted to as well, but I only replaced query because that's the only one that made sense. And we're just using JSONP instead of just a regular get. Then once this is invoked, it'll be assigned once that result is returned, and then I can operate on the JSON just as you normally would using Angular by looping through your results and displaying the tweets. So there you go. Glad you watched the video. If you're interested in following me on Twitter, you can search for me just John Lindquist. And look forward to more tutorials. I do hope to expand on this one to give it some more functionality.